Last time I was talking about the difference between building a slinky or a box as a system. And I want to go on with that thought a little bit further because sometimes we're building systems and we can't figure out why they're not working. We've really put our heart into it. We've got all the pieces we think that are necessary. And yet, in the end, it doesn't produce the results we expect it to produce. And we're just puzzled. And we think we've gotten it right. I was coaching a church planner, and I was helping him to build his connection system. And I was describing to him how to use his Sunday morning greeters to move people from, being first-time visitors to becoming part of the congregation. And here's the steps and things you want to do and things to think about. And he went back and worked with his greeting system and built what he thought was the perfect greeting process. I showed up several Sundays later, and they were so proud to take me through that process, and my wife. And so they brought us in, and they introduced us to some people, and gave us information, and got our information, and gave us coffee and donuts. And then they let us into their auditorium and sat us down. And it was such a weird thing. There was another family in the auditorium, all the way across, too far away to have a conversation with. On the platform, their worship team had just finished their rehearsal, and they were huddled together, praying with each other, and there was no one else in the room. But from where I was sitting, I could hear in the hallway, that there was a party going on, and people were laughing and joking and talking to each other, and I wanted to be out where they were instead of sitting in silence in the big auditorium. And I recognized right away that this church planner I had coached, I thought I'd coached well, actually had built a box instead of a slinky. His connection system wasn't working because he had gotten the functions right, but he had forgotten its purpose. The purpose of a system is how we live and how we build relationships and how we connect with each other. The church systems helps it to live in community. It helps us to pursue a relationship with God together, not individually. And so when we're building systems, it's not about getting people to the right place or getting people to do the right things or putting the right information in their hands. It's about how do we connect deeply with one another and unite in a common purpose? And how do we pursue God in intimacy and fulfill His calling upon us as a congregation within this community? Those are the things to think about as you build your systems so that they don't turn into boxes, but they become slinkies.